What's up, everyone? This is the AfterBuzz TV after show for the Mandalorian Remix Edition, because obviously I'm not in studio and my co-hosts aren't in studio either. Overall thoughts, loved this finale. One of my favorite finales of all time. I think Taika Waititi just knocked it right out of the park.
We knew he was an amazing director, but wow, his style fit right into Star Wars.
The fact that he not only directed this, but was IG-11, who was hands down the MVP of this episode, is just...
I'll have to take credit for knowing that IG-11 was coming back.
IG-11 came back in a really fantastic way, so I take back what I said last episode.
IG-11, oh my gosh, going out Terminator 2 style. I almost expected a thumbs up as he went down into the lava. IG-11, wow, instantly one of the best droids in the franchise.
Everybody else on the panel talked me out of the fact that we were going to see Mando's face, but I really felt like they couldn't do a whole season without showing us what the main character actually looked like.
We had Mando take the helmet off. What? We got his name. Holy crap.
There was a moment where I thought we might lose Mando, even though I knew we were getting a season 2. There was a moment where I thought, oh no, are they going to continue it without him? Really, really glad that he lived. Even though that was probably obvious, but I was a little bit worried there for a second.
Baby Yoda, still there.
Obviously, Baby Yoda, the child, had some really, really funny moments where he's laughing on the speeder when IG-11 is speeding through the town and he's obviously having a fun time. And that was so cute.
We might find out what's going on with him in the future, where he's from. They're attached. They're a duo. They're almost like Kylo Ren and Rey in the Force without all the death.
Great to see a little bit more from Cara Dune as well. That was nice to see her character utilized. I thought that they did it a better job this episode than they did last episode.
Gina Carano giving the best acting I've ever seen her give. She was awesome in this episode.
I was actually surprised at how funny it was too for such a high stakes sort of episode.
Every scene of this episode in general was so action packed.
This episode had everything you wanted. Laughs, awesome action, awesome heart, emotional things that were earned throughout the entire season.
Those fight sequences, that darksaber.
But one thing I was not expecting ever was to see a black lightsaber. Oh.
This is easily the best Star Wars content to come out since the original trilogy. I absolutely loved it.
I'm so excited that Moff Gideon's gonna be around for season 2 and that there's gonna be a season 2. I think that's gonna be a pretty cool mission that Mando has to go on.
I thought it was a great way to end the season and a great way to set up season 2, which I don't know if I can wait for.
I absolutely love this episode. This was the culmination of all 8, and it made this season as good as everyone said this season was going to be.
I absolutely loved this episode. I know I've said it a couple of times before that the last episode is my favorite episode. I think this might be my favorite episode. It was so good.
Can't get enough of it. Can't wait for season 2. Can't wait for Star Wars Clone Wars in February. And cannot wait for our after show.
I can't wait to break it all down with you. And I can't wait to hear your thoughts. So make sure you share with us in the meantime before next week.
On Friday, January 3rd at our usual time of 11 a.m. Pacific.
On AfterBuzz TV. And we can really, really dive in because I'm definitely not done talking about it yet.